2016, we welcome you to the February edition of KUNU.
It was so cool. We got to come out here. It was Grand Awards, and we got to find out like who's going to ICDC, who got the top tests and role plays and whatnot. And I'm just so happy to see my team up there. And I'm just really excited.
It was really cool to get up there. It was the first time I've ever done DECA. Basically, it was the first time he's ever made stage, so it was just a great experience.
I qualified at the national level and I got third place.
We can go dance, we can get a drink. Just the time to party at the end of the week. And then play my song.
Team outings, that kind of thing, because it's really close knit family, and we all enjoy being around each other, I think.
What I like about swim is it's just so much different than all the other sports.
I enjoy swimming with upperclassmen. I enjoy like fun Fridays where we do different relays. Spell ya girl the way you move. Tomorrow ain't real, tonight is all truth.
Gonna have you screaming, I gotta make you say ooh, ooh, ooh.
Hi, I'm Annika Warrington and I'm playing Elle Woods.
Hi, my name's Tim Hull, and I play Emmett Forrest.
I'm Michael Ferns, and I'm playing Elle's dad.
Hi, I'm Aubrey, and I play Serena.
Hi, I'm Jane Peterson, and I play Pilar.
Hi, I'm Tachan, and I play Margot.
My name is Sarah Tyson, and I'm playing Paulette Bonifante. My favorite part about being in a musical is that there's just such an energy in the cast because you're dancing and singing, and you're always together all the time.
I do enjoy interacting, especially with the other actors. There's something about flowing and the whole introducing your kind of style to a new character.
It's super funny, and I laugh like daily when I watch just the rehearsal.
This girl is incredible. I'm gonna miss you so much. Okay.
I'm gonna make my eyeliner run.
Here's a quote from Waiting for Superman. Their academic future will be decided by a school official who will place them on a track. Students placed on lower tracks usually have lower expectations and often worse teachers. Kids could be placed on lower tracks because they earned low test scores or they're failing a core class. Whatever the reason, some students once placed on that lower track will encounter less effective teachers, classes with low expectations, and less challenging material.
Although I agree with you to a certain extent, I must say, once you get picked on a track, it's not set in stone. I was placed in advanced English at the beginning of the year, and I had to work really hard to get into this class, but I did. I had to push pretty hard, but I did get into this class. So it's, if you have the drive, you can get into the higher classes, even if you're not placed in them.
In elementary school, I've gone to three different ones, but the one I went to most of my life was Fairview, and the principal there, I saw very much, there was interaction between him and the students, him and the
teachers and teachers with the students, and it was a much better social capital. Versus when I was in Canada, the principal that I had there was much more of, if you saw her, it was more of an instructional leader than interactions between the teachers and, or with students.
It seemed like if we did good in class today, then he'd like tell us a story or something. So it felt like he kind of gave us a reward if we worked hard, and that kind of motivated me to do better.
Some students are like, I'm never going to use this in my life, but I feel like there's some teachers, like the teacher I had in sixth grade, he could turn anything into how he used it in life. Like anything he taught us, he told us how he used it, and it inspired us to learn it. And he was kind of the happy medium between being really smart and being inspirational.
I did not like school. I did not do anything well in school, but then I had that teacher, and not as much as the inspirational, but they showed you that you could do it. He showed that it was able to be done.
The year off fine.
February,
you're my little Valentine.
March,
I'm gonna march you down the aisle.
April,
you're the Easter bunny when you smile. Yeah, yeah, my heart's in a whirl. I love my little calendar girl.
Every day
of the year.
Oh, hey, I'm Mike Harris, and I want to get you excited. We're going to go flying.
Come fly with me. Let's fly away. You just say those words, and we'll take our birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's so perfect for a flying honeymoon. Oh, babe, come fly with me. Let's fly, let's fly. Up, let's fly away.
And now, 2016 OSA Cheerleading State Champion in the 4X Small Division. Clap of the year.
I'm only one call away. I'll be there to save the day. Superman got nothing on me. I'm only one call away. Call me baby if you need a friend. I just wanna give you love. Come on, come on, come on. Reaching out to you, so take a chance. No matter where you go, you're not alone. I'm only one call away. I'll be there to save the day. Superman got nothing on me.
Well, you just have to be motivated. If you're motivated, you can do whatever you want. And I've been motivated these last 3 years to be a state champion. And the work pays off. And every time you want to quit, you just think about why you're doing it. And once you give it everything you have, that's all you can have left. And it's great. It's a great feeling.
Make it anywhere. But for now, we can stay here for a while. Cause you know, I just want to see you smile. No matter where you go, you know you're not alone. I'm only one.
Thank you.
And that was the February edition of KU and You. Thank you for watching, and until next time.
Yeah, yeah, my heart's in a way.